Young Patrick Hoyle was not quite a man yet when history called him by name. A nation that's now called the Republic of Ireland was by rebellion inflamed. His friends and his neighbors, relations and family together didn't make a great stand. And young Patrick Hoyle, not a man yet, but brave enough, answered the call of Ireland. Unlike many others, young Patrick was not slain, though 18 long months he was held. Inside one of Great Britain's concentration camps, 18 long months of near hell. He returned to Mount Charles, a great local hero, surely some songs to tell. Of the wondrous deeds of young Patrick Hoyle, another Irish rebel. The wide flood of history, the great emigration, swept young Patrick away. He sailed in October and married that very spring, settling in the East USA. Like millions and millions, forever in exile, forever his heart for to roam. The land that he lived for and offered his life for would never again be his home. Not so young Patrick, with a wife and 9 children, lived day to day in East Newark. A job here, a job there, he was strong, proud and able, but he could not get good steady work. A proud man, he died slowly, watching his family scrape by and by day to day. Gave what he had to give, all of it, everything, he lived his life that way.
Of the least of the struggles of Patrick Hoyle,